Hi viewers, welcome back to our channel. We have been discussing the prologue to the Canterbury Tales summary. Now we are going to discuss about the character Friar. The name of the Friar is Hubert. He is wanton and jolly. He is licensed to beg. He is good at gossip, flirtation and flattery. He is familiar with rich farmers and high-placed women. He absorbs sinners readily and gets paid for it. He carries pins and knives in hood to give to fair women. He plays on fiddle. He easily wins prize in singing. His neck is as white as lily. He mingles with innkeepers and barmaids. He extracts money from poor by reading St. John's Gospel. His eyes twinkle as stars. He plays on harp. Friar's name is Hubert. He is wanton and jolly. He is licensed to beg. He is good at gossip, flirtation and flattery. He is familiar with rich farmers, high-placed women. He absorbs sinners readily and gets paid for it. He carries pins and knives in hood to give to fair women. He plays on fiddle. He easily wins prize in singing. His neck is as white as lily. He mingles easily with innkeepers and barmaids. He extracts money from poor by reading St. John's Gospel. His eyes twinkle as stars. He plays on harp. The merchant has fork beard and beaver hat. He fastens his boot. He thinks sea routes between Middleburg and Norwell must be kept safe from pirates. He sells French crowns at profit. We are discussing about merchant. He has fork beard and beaver hat. He fastens his boot. He thinks sea routes between Middleburg and Norwell must be kept safe from pirates. He sells French crowns at profit. The next character is Clerk of Oxford. He is the student of divinity. He likes to have 20 books at bed. He reads Aristotle's philosophy. He is thin and hollow-cheeked. He is a sober. His horse is as thin as rake. He prays for the welfare of his friends who helped him in his studies. He speaks modestly. He is interested in learning and teaching. He has not got rectorship of parish church. Let me repeat, Clerk of Oxford. He is the student of divinity. He likes to have 20 books at bed. He reads Aristotle's philosophy. He is thin and hollow-cheeked. He is sober. His horse is as thin as rake. He prays for the welfare of his friends who help him in his studies. He speaks modestly. He is interested in learning and teaching. He has not got rectorship of Paris Church. The next character is the Sergeant of Law. He wears a multicolored coat. His coat is belted with a silk girdle with small stripes. He is the lawyer of highest degree. He is vigilant and wise. He goes to cathedral to consult the lawyers. His clients give him robes as well as money. He purchases land. He drafts a document flawlessly. Let me repeat the character, the Sergeant of Law. The Sergeant of Law wears a multicolored coat. His coat is belted with a silk girdle with small stripes. He is the lawyer of highest degree. He is vigilant and wise. He goes to cathedral to consult the lawyers. His clients give him robes as well as money. He purchases land. He drafts a document flawlessly. The next character is cook. The cook is good at boiling chicken with marrow bones and making spicy dishes. He has ulcer on lower part of his leg. He is well versed in different method of cooking. Cook is good at boiling chicken with marrow bones and making spicy dishes. He has ulcer on lower part of his leg. Cook is well versed in different method of cooking. So far we have discussed about some characters. The other characters will be continued in the next video. So thank you for watching this. Please subscribe the channel.